A lot of people say how they believe in energies, they believe in Shakti. It's not enough to just believe in energies. It's important to understand them. If you want this to be of benefit to you, if you actually want this to work for you, then you need to figure out how the Shaktis are placed around your body and what is the impact that they have on you. Now, take for example the concept of the cycle of life and death. Now, we know that creation and destruction has to take place in an unceasing and constant cycle for life to be maintained, and that even if one of the two, either creation or destruction, is stopped, even for the briefest time, then life as we know it will be wiped out of existence. And we generally refer to this Shakti as Shiva and Parvati. Parvati as Mother Earth, who creates everything, and Shiva as the destroyer, who will bring everything to an end at the end of time. But this cycle of life and death, this creation and destruction, is not just about the bigger picture of somebody being born and somebody dying. It's much more immediate than that. It takes place in our body every day at all times. According to the Sushrut Samhita, the Sushrut Samhita is, we believe, the first book on Ayurveda, and it's dated to about the 6th or maybe the 5th century BC. And according to the Sushrut Samhita, the upper part of the body, which is the respiratory organs, the lungs, etc., are the Matrika Shakti, the creative metabolism, the Shakti or the energy of Parvati. The lower part of the body, the intestines, etc., are the Pitrika Shakti, the Shakti of Shiva, the destructive metabolism. This is where food is taken to be broken down. This is where the digestive process takes place. And it tells you that if for any reason the Pitrika Shakti is blocked, that your intestines, the digestive process gets blocked, the heat will build up to a great extent in your body, and this will lead to fever and sickness. Now the thing is, we all know this, but we forget that this is actually a very, very powerful Shakti. It is literally the Shakti of creation and destruction that exists within us. And so we don't really take the time to give it that kind of importance that it should have. We don't give it enough time and understanding to balance it out. So this week, this is what I would like you to do. I want you to really concentrate on understanding how the energies move through your body. Where is the Shakti sitting, and what is the impact that it is having on you? Is it in sync, the upper half and the lower half of your body? Or are you paying more attention to one and less to the other? Are you spending more time building up your pecs and not really worrying about what's happening to your core? Or are you focusing on your core and not worrying about the upper part of your body? This week, I want you to try and find a balance in your Shaktis, because it is this balance that will ultimately lead to your good health, both mentally as well as physically.